Hello everyone, so here in this video I have two cubes, one scramble and one solved one. Now before we get into the details of how to unscramble this scramble cube, let's understand the basic structure of a 3x3 Rubik cube, because it's gonna be very important once you start solving it. Alright, so in one 3x3 Rubik cube there are three kind of cubes, or we call them pieces as well. The very first one is the centerpiece. There are six color centerpieces which are fixed in one place. They rotate, but they never move from its place. So if white is opposite yellow, blue is opposite green, red is opposite orange, it's gonna remain like this. We can have better understanding of centerpieces by doing a little trick over here. As you can see, I have moved most of the pieces of this cube, but centerpieces are still fixed in its place. Like white is still opposite yellow, blue is still opposite green, and red is still opposite orange. Now the second type of piece or cube is the edge cube, which is made of two colors and it's always placed in between the corners. Like this edge piece is in between these two corners, this edge piece is in between these two corners. The third type of cube or piece is the corner piece, and it's made of three colors. Like this corner piece is made of 1, 2, 3. Like same way, this corner piece is also made of three colors, 1, 2, 3, and likewise in whole cube. Now, the scramble cube, we solve this cube in three steps. So the first step would be to make a cross of one color. Now, I choose that color to be white because I have always practiced it with white color. And I would suggest that you also choose white color so that we don't have any problem in coordination. But otherwise, you can make cross with any color. So the first step is to make the cross. Then in second step, we'll solve first two layers together by using F2L algorithm, and F2L stands for first two layers. So these two layers will be solved together, and in third means last step, we'll solve our third layer, and that's how we are going to refer this cube, where we'll make the cross, we'll call that first layer, then just below that means middle layer we'll call second layer, and the last layer we'll call third layer. Now, to make the cross, first of all, we should keep the center piece of white color in the top layer, because I'm going to make the white color cross. Therefore, I'm keeping the center piece of white color in the top layer. The next thing we should do is to look for four such edge pieces in which one color has to be white and another color of that edge piece should match with these four center pieces. Like for an example here, this orange and white edge piece is actually currently in the right place but not in the right position. So what I mean to say is that I have to flip this edge piece so that I can match white with the white and orange with the orange. And likewise, I need to fix three more edges in the right place. Now the process of making cross is very intuitive and it's extremely easy. Well, in this video, I'll show you how can you minimize the number of steps for doing so. However, I would strongly advise you to practice this step as much as you can, because it will help you to get familiar with this cube. So let's first fix this edge piece in the right position. As I told you, it's in the right place but not in the right position. Before we do that, we should check if any of other edge piece is fixed in the right place. In case if there was any, we should have been careful about not disturbing that one. But for now, since none of them is fixed, we can just simply go ahead and do our normal step to fix this in the right positions. What we have to do is, first of all, we should take this edge piece away from the center piece. It can be on the right hand side, or we can take this edge piece on the left hand side. And next, we have to match the side color of the edge piece to the center piece. And once it's matched, we bring the layer up to match white with the white. But if even one edge piece is fixed in right place, like this one, now this red and white is fixed in the right place, in this situation we have to be careful about not disturbing this. Therefore, what we have to do now is that first we'll simply take this away from the center piece, whether on the right or left. And now when we bring it down to match with the side color of the edge piece to the center piece, this is fine till now, but before we bring this up in the top layer to match white with the white, first we should fix this edge piece back, so that when we bring this up, both of them are set. In case if we were not careful about fixing the solved part first, In this situation, what we would have done is we would have messed this solved part. So now if I want to fix this back, I will not be able to do that, because if I fix this, I'm spoiling this one. So one of them is gonna messed up. Therefore, we should always be careful about fixing the solved part first and then move on to the next one. Cool. Let's see how to bring the edge piece in the right place if they are in second layer, whether here or here, means on the right hand side or left hand side. In this situation, first of all, we should take the edge piece down in third layer so that we can bring the edge piece side color to match with the center piece. And now we can simply bring it up in top layer so that we can match white with the white. In the same way, if this edge piece was here on the left hand side, in this situation also we would have done the same thing. We should have bring this edge piece, this edge piece down in third layer, and now bring it to match with the center piece. Now when we bring it up to top layer, the white is matched. Cool. There could be another way where, you know, if this edge piece was already set up like this, in this situation you don't have to bring it down to the third layer, you can just simply take it up on the top to match white with the white. In this situation also, when we are setting up the edge piece from the second layer to the top layer in the right place, we should be careful about the solved, like the fixed edges. So this edge is fixed. In this situation, when we bring this edge piece down in third layer, this piece comes along, and if we are not careful about fixing this first, we'll ruin it. Therefore, when we, as you can see that when we bring this edge piece down, this layer is moving. Therefore, we should take this edge piece away from this layer first, so that when we take this layer back up to fix the edge piece in the right place, this is fixed, and now we can bring this edge piece back up to fix this one too. So that's how we are done with these two together. So we already know how to bring the edge piece from here or here or here to the top layer in the right position or in the right place. Now the edge piece is in the down layer, in the bottom layer, we call it a third layer as well. So from this layer, how to take the edge piece in the right place, we are going to have the same approach as we did when we were fixing the orange and white piece in the right position. Therefore, what we have to do, we just have to take this edge piece away from the center piece like this. But before I go ahead, I should tell you that two edges are already fixed, and in this situation we have to be careful about not disturbing the solved part. Therefore, as you can see that when I take this edge piece here to match the side color of the edge piece to the center piece, this edge piece will go away like this. This is here, this is matched, but this is here. But we don't have to worry about that. First, we can take it up to match white with the white, and now we can bring it back to fix this back. Alright, so finally let me tell you how to make a cross. Like I have told you how to bring any edge piece from any of these four places to the right place, but for now I'll tell you how to quickly make a cross. Like this is red and white edge piece. Now white is on the top, so I just have to match the side color of this red to the center piece. So I will simply take it to the red and it's matched. So this is done. Now the second edge piece is here in front of me, green and white. So this is the first thing which I told you about, when I was flipping the orange and white piece, right? So we have to take this edge piece away from the center piece. We take it away, we match the side color of the edge piece to the center piece, and first we fix the solved part. So I'm gonna take this back, and now I will bring this up. So this is also done. Now the third edge piece I can see is here. This is orange and white. So first, this is already away from the center piece, so I just have to simply take it to the, take the cycle of the edge piece to the center piece, and now I have to bring it up to match white with the white, and I'll bring this green back. Cool. The fourth edge piece is here. I simply have to take it below the center piece of blue color and bring it up, and that's how we complete the cross. Isn't it easy? As I told you, it's very intuitive. You should practice this step as much as you can, because with practice you can do this particular step under 5 seconds, and that's commendable, right? So I very strongly advise you to practice this as much as you can. Cool.
Hey guys, please subscribe my channel for more videos on cube tutorials, and please do not forget to like, comment and share this video. Please subscribe. See ya.